The next speaker is Nelson Villagra from Universidad Nacional de la Patagonia San Juan Bosco. The title is Cold Affinity Propagation Algorithm Biofield Protein-Protein Interactions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the presentation. I'm Nelson. I'm a PhD student in Comodoro Rivadavia. It's a city near here. It's over 400 kilometers down south. It's not really nice, but if you want to go, you can you can go to visit us. Here is the group, the people we are working with. This is a really important person here in this problem. He's a biologist. Him and Roxana, they are two biologists that have been studying this bacteria, this problem for several years. We put our noses, Pablo, Gabriel, and me, recently, but they have shown that the bacteria called Rhodococcus hosti, has the ability to accumulate triglycerides under stress conditions. It's a bacteria that is autochthonous of the area. It grows in really dry areas like my city, and it has that important ability that could. This is the biofuel here. It's that that triglycerides could be used for the production of. Bacterial biofuel. So, this is an overview. I'm going to talk about a little about the biological problem, the data that we have. We are working with the proteomic data of that bacteria. For now, we are doing some clustering situations. Anything else? I'm going to talk about. Some methodology about the algorithm we are using, some really, really, really preliminary results. This is a working process, so it's really small things we can say. Some little conclusions and future work. Okay, at first, that's the bacteria, that's the Rhodococcus. The circles you can see are little bubbles, little vesicles filled with triglycerides. Yes, it's really fatty. This bacteria, it's full under nitrogen deprivation state. It takes this form. It's full with triglycerides.
Sorry, I don't understand. Full of what?
Triglycerides. It's fatty acid. Sorry for my pronunciation.
Understand now, because on the
website
I don't understand.
Okay. Okay, as I told you before, it has the ability to grow in a broad spectrum of organic compounds. This is really interesting because it basically grows in garbage, in industrial residual of waste produced from industrial. So it's really nice, this bacteria, because for this situation, and for this situation, it's really good to explore that situation that's currently with it. It's an hologenous microorganism that has the characteristic that I have told you before. It has it could accumulate more than 20% of its cellular weight of these triglycerides. For this is a high value research for biodiesel production, and its interactome is less than 50%. This is taken by the KIEG database, genome and transcriptome is complete, but until this moment we haven't used that information. Our main objective now is to use data mining to characterize those interactions, and maybe more than interactions, to find some functional processes. Okay, this is this is some picture of the reflux of, the restructuration of carbon flux in the bacteria here in nitrogen poor conditions. I didn't put the another images what is with nutrients because here there are interesting facts. Glycolysis, it's downregulated, but appears the AD pathway for it, for the glycolysis, for processing the glucose. And well, here it's a real instrument regulator called as the nitron lipid regulator, who when it appears, it it changes all this picture. Here it's involved in the Kennedy pathway too, which is the main reason to process these triglycerides. This is the picture we are trying to get more information about. This has been proved in laboratory by Hector and Roxana, but there are a lot of things that they really don't know what is happening inside this bacteria. Okay, we are working with this proteomic data, with this level 3 quantification. It's a method in mass spectrometry that aims to determine the relative amount of proteins in two or more biological samples. They did it in a normal condition and under nitrogen starvation. This experiment, they send the samples to Germany. This cannot be done here in Argentina, and I don't know if it is possible to do it nearby. Our aim is to try to characterize the PPA map for this bacteria, and we are using at this point we are using affinity propagation algorithm to analyze this proteomic data and to try to identify groups in this data, trying to find groups of functional or maybe interacting proteins. And we are trying to pay special attention to these non-regulators and maybe to find new ones. The regulators are here and here in this diagram, but they are really special proteins because when they appear, they change much of the pathways. They produce a lot of changes in the structure. Okay, the algorithm, it's called affinity propagation. It was published in Science in the year 2007, I think. It's a non-supervised fast and Laurer algorithm. Take as input the distance matrix between the data. So we use at this point we are using Euclidean distance. This is only for preliminary process. We are trying to find a distance more related to something meaningful to this interactions or functionality. It considers all data points as potential exemplars. There is an exchange of messages during the processes. One of the messages is the responsibility, and the other is the availability. They all have to do with this this distance matrix that they use as input for it. And the interesting fact is that you have to define the number of clusters. When we use, at first we use more simpler forms to cluster the data, but hierarchical wasn't possible because of the visualization of the problem. We had over 2,200 proteins, so we had a really large dendrogram, and we have any significant cuts to do. Maybe k-means, it's a known algorithm too, but you have to put it. You have to put the amount of clusters you have for the you want for the data, and that's a thing we don't know. So this is a really important thing for us to use this algorithm. Well, the goal of the AP algorithm is to minimize the overall sum of similarities between the data points and their examples. This is something about the algorithm. This is responsibility. It basically reflects the accumulated evidence of how suitable is a point to be an exemplar. The other message is the availability. Here is the formula to calculate it. And basically reflects how appropriate it would be for a point E to choose a point K as its exemplar. Yes, this is the message that the points exchange, and at last you find some clusters, a proper number of clusters, and each one with the corresponding exemplar. The criterion metrics is how the algorithm converges. It takes the highest criterion value of each row. This is a matrix, no? It's the sum of the two messages. These are two matrices too. The highest value of each row is designated as exemplar, and rows that share the same exemplar are in the same cluster. It's really easy to calculate it, and this is all in the program, basically. So you can use it to break the algorithm in any moment, or you can leave it to iterate until there is no changes in this matrix, and you have the output there.